equation of motion. Now the derivation of the equation of motion, we use vt graph. We use vt graph for the derivation of equations of motion. Suppose this is the velocity time graph. The initial velocity of the body is u. This is u. At the final velocity, after traveling a certain distance, we can say after t times, the velocity of the body changes to v. Let the body has a constant acceleration a. So first, what we have to do, we have to explain all the terms which you are using here, like what is u, what is v, what is t, and what is a, all this. So first, you will say that let a body is moving with the initial velocity of u after traveling a distance s with constant acceleration a. In time t, its velocity changes to v. So this is the graph called velocity time graph. In first part, we have to calculate for the first equation of motion v is equal to u plus a t. We have to calculate the acceleration of the graph, the acceleration of the body. So how can we calculate acceleration? Yes, q. From vt graph, how can we calculate acceleration? And adding here some points a, b, wait a minute, c and d. Yes, no. Yes. Find out the slope. What do you mean by slope of the graph? No. Yes. U. Slope is? What do you mean by slope? Slope is? Okay, next to you. What do you mean by slope of the graph? I explained the meaning of slope in last lecture. On last Saturday.
Perpendicular upon base.
Yes, we know that slope AB is this perpendicular upon this base. So we can say BC upon EC. And what is the length of BC? How can we calculate the length of BC? Sit down. What is the length of this BC? Yes?
BD minus CD.
Yes, we can subtract this CD from this whole length BD for the calculation of BC. So BC will be BD minus CD upon AC will be equal to 4. Now put all the values here. Like A is equal to BD is B and CD is U and this is sine T. And by cross multiplication we get AT is equal to B minus U, or we can say B is equal to U plus AT. Now, what's most important thing, this is equation 1. This is equation 1. We have to write here equation 1. For other two derivations, that is second and the third derivation, first you have to derive this first term. Because from this derivation, we put the values from this equation 1. So, for other two derivations, that is 2 and 3, we have to derive this first derivation. Is this clear? For the second derivation, first you have to derive this first equation. In second derivation, we know that second equation is s is equal to ut plus half at square. So in this equation of motion, we have to calculate the distance covered.
Yes, ma'am.
Then how can we calculate the distance covered here? Yes. How can we calculate distance covered here, displacement by the body, by vt curve? Yes, very good. So we draw the perpendicular from both the points and by taking the area of this whole figure. Since this figure is in the form of trapezium. So by taking the area of this whole figure, we can easily calculate the distance curve. Now for second derivation, you should remember that you can divide this part into two parts. Yes, yes. So we have to remember that for second derivation, we will divide it into two parts, triangle plus rectangle. So we will say distance is equal to area of triangle, but I am writing the notebook. ABC plus area of rectangle, that is ACBO. What is the area of this triangle? Yes, Sheetal?
Half into.
Yes.
Half
into.
Perpendicular of AC.
What is perpendicular?
Perpendicular AB.
AB is perpendicular.
BC. Sorry, BC.
BC, okay. BC and. From equation 1. s is equal to 1 upon 2 b square minus b square. This is the identity, third identity. A plus b minus b square, a square minus b square. So it will be b square minus u square upon a. And by cross integration, we will get 2as is equal to b square minus u square. Or we can say b square is equal to u square plus 2as. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
This is called the third derivation. And this is all about this chapter. I think one more topic is here. Okay, first write down this derivation in the notebook. One more time, for calculating for the derivation of third derivation, for the first third derivation, first we have to do first derivation. Okay, it is composite. And then you will find out the distance by finding the area of trapezium. This is the trapezium. And you know that the trapezium having the area 1.2 like some of the other side?
Yes, ma'am.
So here in this figure, the height is this one only. This is the height. And these are the two parallel sides. Okay? So we find out the distance is equal to 1.2, height is t, and parallel sides is u and v. Now, you put the value of t from equation 1. In equation 1, you know that a is equal to v minus u. So, the t will be equal to v minus u upon a. You will put the values here. And then v minus u, v plus u will become v square minus u square. And by cross multiplication, we get the value v square is equal to u square plus u square. Okay. A very simple topic. I think which is remaining is a uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion means if a body is traveling in a circular motion like this, having a radius r, so this type of motion in which it has a uniform speed, this is called uniform circular motion. You know the uniform circular motion is called accelerated motion. Okay. First write down this equation in the notebook.
Then displacement will be zero.
Body is traveling in a circular motion with a constant speed. This type of motion is called uniform circular motion. So in this motion, if a body starts from here and again come back to this point, you will see that the distance of the body will be required to circumference of the circle.
Yes, ma'am.
And what is about the acceleration? Is this body has a constant velocity or not?
No, ma'am.
It is. It has non-uniform velocity. Can anyone explain me why this velocity, why the velocity of this body has non uniform? Though the speed of the body is constant.
And because the direction of the body changes.
Yes. Because at every point the direction of the body changes. The direction at this point will be like this. The perpendicular to this radius. This is called tangent. And at this point again this will be the perpendicular of this radius. So at every movement, at every time, the direction of the body changes. So we can say it will have non-uniform velocity. Or if a body has non-uniform velocity, then this type of motion is called accelerated motion. So when a body is traveling in a circular path with a constant speed, it says it has a uniform speed, but its motion is accelerated motion. Yes, its velocity changes, so its acceleration is. So, it has an accelerated motion. So, sometimes the question is like that. When the body is traveling in a circular path with a constant speed, why? This is called the accelerated motion. So, you have to write down here. The velocity of the movement in a circular path changes. So, that side the acceleration of the body will be there. So, this type of motion is called accelerated motion.